Welcome back to Last Humans Garage. I always got to say that. It's kind of dumb, actually. Today, we're just going to look at the new rear sway bar, which arrived. This is not an install video. That will be coming later. So let's get right into it. Still kind of bummed about that Golf spoiler that I bought. No luck selling it local yet. So I'm going to clean up those ends, tighten it up, box it, and probably sell it back online. Should make all my money back on that. It's a nice piece, but yeah, it's not a highly desirable piece local. You know, not a lot of golf owners want to spruce up their exterior. That's the bottom line. All right, let's get to the new speed rear sway bar. Just to touch on the Moog end links first, really sweet replacements for those little pinner crappy VW ones. Real nice quality, and the important thing, you get your grease, your greaser right there. And let me just make sure this, yeah, nice and tight. I just wanted to get the stress off of that boot and, you know, grease them later on. But yeah, I will be, these are heavy too. I bet they're twice as heavy as the stalkers, but hey, you can't win them all in the battle for weight, right? Those are nice and substantial. So that's just a compliment to the part. All right, so yes, I went with the new speed. A lot of people do like that one. I did go at 25 mil, as you can see. Of course, I did get this from DAP Auto, Deutsch Auto Parts, my number one parts supplier and sponsor for the channel. I'm sure tons of you guys use that. There's other options, but I always love going to Deutsch Auto Parts, and they have just about anything I need, and they can order just about anything else I need. So I definitely like working with Paul and the team for the channel as my primary parts source. Let's go ahead and see what we got here. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and tripod you up because I don't wanna be holding the camera, doing all that half-assed stuff like usual. I'm gonna go ahead and get you set up here and I'll be right back. That looks like a beautiful shot right there. Although my head might be off of the screen, but you don't care about that. You want to see the action. Oh man, this thing's heavy. All right. So, before we look at that, I'll just show you here. My favorite wheels on the new speeds are not the 10s or the 12s, the 16s. 16 spoke is what that means. Those are my favorite, the 16s. I love that the most. I love this. Is it one? Yeah, this 122 here. I haven't seen that one before. So I love the 122s and I love the RE. Where's my finger? The RE16s here. But as you know, those are $3,350 a piece. $1,200 to $1,300 plus just for the wheels. Then you got to buy 800 in tires. $2,000. Not for me. I don't have that kind of money. But so the new speed just comes with your frame. Frame bushings, of course. A little bit of lube. What I've learned on these over many sway bar installs over my life is do not overdo this. It's going to squirt out the sides. It's going to collect dirt and dust and just make a mess. So on this one, I'm going to pay a little extra attention when you get to the install video sometime in the next few days. I'm going to try not to get it on the edges, like the center, and let it naturally squirt a little bit on the edge. You know, you don't want your squeaks. But I don't want it bulging out everywhere. All it does is make a mess. So keep that in mind too, if you're doing one of these installs. All right, these are easy to unpack here. Oh, that one was tight. All right, I do not want to scratch up this red paint, even though it'll get scratched the second I install it. Let me very carefully cut off that. All right. I can probably shank it out just like that. Oh, look at that color. Oh, yes. Oh my God, that is a lot smaller. Geez, that's short. More than I expected. That's really short, really cool, really heavy. I definitely like the red. I like the new speed, little part number right there. Man, this is definitely a solid bar because it's way too heavy to be a hollow, which is fine too. The hollows are for weight savings a little bit, but you lose a little bit of rigidity. So this is overall killer. I also love, not every sway bar has this, and some of them have temporary add-on ones that you got to Allen in, and they're never going to stick quite right. What I really like about this is super solid. It does not move, and it locks those, the frames, I would guess, go on the outsides here, is my guess. They're not going to fit here. So it keeps it from sliding back and forth there, you know, like that. All right. I am stoked to get this sway on this car at some point soon. Am I not in the camera? Everybody says it's the number, it's in the top three most important mods to do. I always thought the car just handled good, but I want to try it for sure. I really hope I keep it and enjoy it. That's my goal. And I hope it keeps the back a little more stable on the corners. Even if it slides with the new traction settings I found, and the way I can push the car more, I think I could control it better also. So I'm really psyched. But I've also found with the rear sways is somehow, I mean, it all makes sense in the end. The steering is always much more quick and tighter in the front because it's, you know, it isn't flexing when you steer. So the steering, when I found, it takes less turn after I install these things to do the same handling. So in that sense, it also improves the handling. All right, guys, I don't want to drag this out. This is just an unboxing video, and I'm running out of breath already. Thanks for watching. I'm going to get to this when I can for the install. I'm probably just going to do rear on the ramps. I'm not going to get it flat or anything like that. The most important thing in my eyes for the rear sway, don't have the wheels hanging when you tighten those bolts. So you go up on ramps and it sits just like that, but on ramps. I do not think I need to raise that front to be equal. That's such a minor difference. I don't think that is necessary. But, you know, we'll see. We'll see what you guys say on that as I'm not installing at this moment. See if I get any comments on that, any tips, advice, etc. Future stuff real quick. I'm probably going to be taking off those side skirts, painting them gloss black to really pop with the wheels. I've done that on a lot of cars. I think it's one or two bolts and you slide it off of its slot. I'm not sure on that. I got to make sure. And spoiler, of course, wrecked. I'm still looking for spoiler ideas and solutions. I've seen everyone out there, the Aerosport, the Max, all the eBays, all the carbon fibers, all the ECS. Nothing is really standing out to me. My goal would be to have this spoiler right here, professionally painted black. I'd have to remove it, bring it to a shop, be down about a week, maybe 2 weeks with it open. Holes, if there's a rainstorm, it could destroy the car. Maybe you guys have tips on that. But I am still sourcing out a used one that I could paint in the meantime and then do my swap. I did find a used one for, I believe, under 300 shipped. I believe it's a dark blue. Of course, it needs paint, but that would be quite a bit more expensive. $200 to $300 just for the piece. Paint it. Most shops would charge me probably around $200 at least for a professional paint job. So I'd be in $500-$600 for a stock spoiler. Not the best thing in the world. So I'm thinking about that too. Always looking for the TCR rear valance. Not looking for it, just kind of thinking about it. That's another $200 to $300. So there's definitely stuff planned. I'm super psyched. I'll see you guys later. One last thing, as I'm getting really into this car lately. I'm gonna put on my louder resonator back in. I'm talking about the cat-back resonator. I'm gonna replace my vibrant resonator with the OEM one again, get a little more throat and howl out of that exhaust for a while till I get tired of it. and I'll probably reinstall those pops and bangs from the Unitronic tune just for fun again. More excited about it now that you know I'm getting into the car a little bit more. So I'll probably mess with that too. So yeah, I'll be working on that this week. See you guys.